मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट, आई एम आलोक ब्रावे फ्रॉम अंबुजा पब्लिक स्कूल, वंस अगेन प्रेजेंटिंग अनदर वीडियो ऑन द चैप्टर फर्स्ट ऑफ द हिस्ट्री, राइट? एंड इन चैप्टर फर्स्ट हिस्ट्री विजुलाइजिंग द नेशंस, चैप्टर फर्स्ट हिस्ट्री, राइट? सी, इन दिस चैप्टर, यू नो माय डियर स्टूडेंट्स, we will study about the allegory, right? That how they used to visualize the nation, how they used to visualize the nation, right? See, my dear student, you know, during that time, you know, see, in the 19th century, what people did, people found a way to represent the country. What is the way? That is they started making the portrait, or you can say statues of female figures. And most of the country has allegory in the form of female figures, right? See, so allegory means symbol. In simple language we can call it symbol. In simple language we can call it symbol. Right? In simple language we can call it symbol. But its other meaning is related with abstract idea of representing a thing. So we can call it allegory. So my dear student, you know, most of the nation of the Europe started making allegories. Right, these allegories were symbol of their nation, right? And the nation is represented in the form of allegory. France has also an allegory. Germany has France, Germany, India, and various other countries. They have allegories in the female form. See, in India we call it Bharat Mata. Bharat Mata. See, France, Marianne. Right, Germany, we have allegory of, you know, Germania. Right, see, Germania. See, most of the countries started following this trend. After the French Revolution, you know, female figures were developed to portray their idea. My dear student, so France kept the name of his allegory, Marianne. Germany kept as Germania. India kept as Bharat Mata Ki Jai. Right, see, Bharat Mata. See, these ideals were represented through specific object or a portrait or a, you can say, statue. Right, see, so liberty was also an allegory who is considered as goddess of, you know, my dear student, freedom, liberty. Right, see, so that is why these allegories were made by the people to influence the people that their country represent such a figure. Right, see, so this is an important thing happened in the you know, in the movement of nationalist movement, or you can say liberalist movement. So similarly, you know, German nation has allegory of the German Germania, right? See, so this lady is wearing, you know, this goddess is wearing, you know, crown, right? See, one crown which is made of oak leaves, such as German oak stand for heroism, right? See, so my dear student, this nation was visualized in the form of, you know, my dear student, you know, allegories, right? Then we had a last topic, nationalism and imperialism. Now, the last topic of this chapter was nationalism and imperialism. The major powers in, you know, my dear student, nationalism and imperialism, you all know about the nationalism and imperialism. See, this is the most important thing we should know. We should understand what is nationalism. Nationalism means, you know, patriotism, right? Means collection of the people, or you know, unity of the people on the basis of race, traditions, cultures, right, by birth, right? See, so, and imperialism means rule by monarchy. Both the things are totally different, right? See, by, you know, in the 19th century's last quarter, idealistic liberal democratic sentiment of the first half of the country became very popular, right? But you know, there was the other side, you know, my dear student, that is imperialism. This imperialism was against these liberal democratic ideas, right? Because it affect their rule directly. So my dear student, most of the country rejected the idea of liberalism under the those who were ruled by the monarchy. So in the Europe, major European, or you can say major European powers, right, you know, does not allow to grow the liberal nationalism. It takes long time to grow the liberal nationalism. So my dear student, this is an important thing. So now we are going to talk today about the Balkan region, right? So Balkan region was very popular region, and you know, after, you know, liberty of, you know, Germany, right, after liberty of, you know, Italy, unification of Italy and Germany. Now, the Balkan area was full of tension, right? Balkan region was full of tension. These regions include Romania, Bulgaria, Albania, right? Montenegro, right? Then we have, you know, Bosnia-Herzegovina, right? Then Slovenia, Serbia, Montenegro, right? These were also known as Slavs, right? See, in this portion, you know, there was high tension among the, you know, Balkan region. Why? Because these Balkans have enmity with each other, right? These Balkans have enmity with each other, and they wanted to capture as much as territory of other Balkan regions, because you know these territories were very important for the trade routes were there. So every Balkan was ready to fight with each other, and they started fighting with each other in order to capture the more and more regions for their nation. So my dear student, this spread of romanticism has forced Balkan, right, the idea of romanticism, nationalism in the Balkan regions, together with the disintegration of the Ottoman Empire, made this region very explosive. And you know, every state of the Balkan after segregating from Ottoman Empire due to the its weakness, right, the Ottoman Empire gradually started become weak, and you know, after its weakness, they wanted to capture as much as area of the Balkan region, right? So they started fighting with each other. So now, you know, there were other European powers who were watching this episode very seriously, right? Like, you know, my dear student, England, Prussia, Russia, and Austria. They were also watching this situation very seriously, right? See, because they have also interest in these regions, right? So they wanted to capture the Europe, then this was the way to capture the Europe. So my dear student, you know, the Balkan people raised their claim for independence or political right after the disintegration of the, you know, this Ottoman Empire, right? See, now see, the Balkans during the tension time in this region, you know, Russia, Germany, England, and Austro-Hungary, they were also keeping very close eye on this region. Who? Russia, England, Austria, Hungary, and Germany were keeping close eye on this region, right? So this region became very explosive. After the disintegration of Ottoman Empire, as Balkans countries or state wanted to capture more and more territory, so they started fighting. See, now there were these four powers when they saw that they are these Balkan region, they are not, you know, they have no understanding. So my dear student, they were keeping close eye on the exposure of this region, like Russian, Austria, right, Hungary, Japan, England and Germany. They wanted to take the benefit of their actually this explosive situation. So my dear student, you know, so every country wanted to control this region, and it led to the first world war. This situation led to first world war. You know, nationalism aligned with imperialism. Led to Europe in disaster in 1940. Right. So, my dear student, this was happened in the year 1914. Right. World War. Right. In World War, you know, there were great damages. Suffered to the various countries, right? See, now, so my dear student, the anti-imperial movement that developed everywhere were nationalist, in the sense that they all struggled to form independent nation. This is the crux of the nationalism and imperialism. They were became against the imperial rule. So they want nation establishment of their nation state, right? So this process was started since 1789, right? See, 1789, this process was started and continued till first world war, right? See, you know, where in the meantime various countries were got independence, they become nation state, right? European ideas of nationalism were nowhere replicated, for people everywhere developed their own specific variety. Specific variety of their own idea, right? See, European ideas were not shown anywhere in the movement of nationalism, right? See, which was started during the French time. So, but the idea that society should be organized into nation state came to be accepted as natural and universal, and this is natural idea that every person has born free, right? And no countries or no territory was allotted to human beings by the God. So this was an important issue. So my dear student, this issue was adopted by the people, right? By the socialist, by the nationalist, according to their feeling, no people is born in this world with property, with territory, with money, right? So everybody is equal, and nobody should be allowed to get all the privileges by the birth. All men are equal because they are made in equality by the God. Thank you today, my dear student. I hope that you will see this video and like. Okay, good day.